That don't even sound right. Yeah. Over down 119, and not in overtime. We won by 20.
You just got to wake up. That's it.
Ernie, do we have the East or the West this year?
We have the West. They've won two in a row in five of their last six.
Well, why don't y'all go ahead and get them reservations and go to State out the way so we can get them good hotels.
That Four Seasons.
Reservation has been made. The request has been made. Would you like to hear what Pop had to say after the game?
Not really, but go ahead.
Sure you would.
Aren't we supposed to interview the winning team?
You always want to hear what Pop has to say.
Well, let me just say, whether you win a game or lose a game, it's a game of mistakes. Both teams have turnovers, there's missed shots, there's bad decisions. Passes that should be made aren't made, shots that shouldn't be shot are shot. So, sort of a moot point. We lost against the best team in the world, and there's a lot of things we need to improve, but I can guarantee you Steve will show film, and there'll be things they'll go over the same thing they do as far as mistakes are concerned. So.
How did you feel the game was official?
So you're trying to get me in trouble. You're trying to get me in trouble.
No, I'm just...
It's my money, not yours.
That's true.
Right?
You got a little
more. So I'm just going to ignore your question.
It's
just basketball.
It's just basketball.
It's just basketball. You know, you win, you lose. If you win, you do it with grace. If you lose, you try to do it with grace.
He reported that you said Kawhi should be back or could be back within 3 weeks.
So. You can't trust the media. Come on.
See, I told you, you always want to hear what Pop has to say, even after a win or a loss.
That's true.
He has a better sense of humor this year. That was funny.
Yeah, I tell you what, the guy's just amazing. I mean, he's got, first of all, he's obviously in the conversation, the greatest NBA coach ever.
I agree with that.
But the way I love hearing him talk about politics and things like that. Man, turn your phone off.
That's not me. Come on, that's a fool.
That's not me. That's Kenny. That's Kenny. My phone ain't even on. That's Kenny right there.
That wasn't me.
It's one of y'all.
That's Kenny over there.
But you know, Ernie, the thing I was saying about...
That wasn't me.
About Pop.
No, not just forget about Popper at the moment.
That's
what I was saying.
That's what you were talking about.
No. But I said my next point to make. What I was saying, this was these are typical NBA. The Spurs are NBA team now. Like I said, everybody got good players. There's no bad players in the NBA. But what separates the bottom feeders or mediocre 500 team is you plug a Kawhi Leonard in, and they go from winning 40 games to 60 games. That's the difference between being a superstar and just having good players. And that's if you don't have a superstar, you can't get to the next level because all the other guys got good players.
So why are all these guys getting max contracts? No, okay, I'll leave that alone.
So Golden State's won 5 out
of
6.
We need to have that conversation.
has won 5 out of 6.
Come to the game in the spaceship, aren't you?
I tell you, no doubt in my mind, if I played today, I'd be coming to the game in the spaceship. Me and Leroy Jetson.
That's how much money they'd have to pay.
Some of these guys, they pair them. They need to back up to the window with a blindfold.
Yeah. Kenny, you got anything to add to the game we actually saw?
Yeah, there's some guys that need blindfolds. But what I would say is, you know, the expectations. Charles, you know, joked, and we were joking about how we'll make your reservations.
You know, I wasn't joking.
You know, but the Golden State Warriors have the ability, as we see, to separate themselves from the rest of the pack. And, you know, when they would lost a couple of games, people were like, oh, are you worried? No. And honestly, and I know you might not agree, I think Cleveland Cavaliers feel that way as well. They could turn on and get a 9-10 game winning streak at any time. And I think that's part of the problem right now. Because the guys who are new that are coming in that environment, they think that too. But not really understanding that there's a reason why they were able to turn it on. And once those guys figure it out and start playing with the best player in the world, who's still LeBron James at this point.
But they're not.
Okay.
Because number one, they got a couple older guys on the team who are past their prime. But that floor is starting to shrink on LeBron James. Kyrie Irving was a better three-point shooter. J.R. Smith is not playing. He's not shooting. I mean, he's all messed up mentally because he's not starting.
Well, he's back to starting. He's starting.
But I'm saying that. But he hasn't played well the last couple of years since they won that championship. That's the last time JR's played well. But the floor is starting to shrink on LeBron, and he's having to work harder. But, you know, like I say, they don't have – everybody's built their team now where we want all three-point shooters. But the Cavaliers got guys out there who can't make threes. So a step here, there, they can't cheat. They can cheat over – and
No one scares him in the East. But think about this, Chuck. The guys that you're talking about, like Derrick Rose and Dwayne Wade.
Yeah.
You know, they won't be playing against Klay Thompson and Steph Curry. They'll be playing against McCall and Nick Young. They'll be playing against second unit guys. And those guys are clearly better when Isaiah Thomas comes into that lineup than everyone. Remember, I always say, you don't have to be the best player. You just have to be the player that can help everybody get into their right spot. And at times, I know I wasn't the best player on the team in the NBA, but I was able to put your best two guard, he could stay a two guard. Your best small forward could stay a small forward. But now, everyone is in rotation, and they're not in their best play. When everyone gets back, that team is...
And not only that, Kane, to add to your point, speaking of the Cavaliers, right now, you know, with LeBron and what he's done, the guys are playing a little too cool. Like, you know, we was watching the game the other day. The effort's just not there. Turn it up a little bit, I think they'll be able to get by Chuck. But right now, the effort is not there.
When you get older and you turn it up, it ain't there. It ain't there. There's going to be so much pressure on Isaiah Thomas when he come back because he's going to have to play, and he's going to have to play well.
But isn't that what he does? His pressure is like he's got to replace Kyrie, and he's going to
be ready.
He does that anyway.
He's going to have to play well because, listen, in the NBA, when you get older, them other players you're playing against, the John Walls, the Bradley Beals, guys like that, you're going to need those guys to get – it's going to be a long playoff run. The Cavaliers, the East just going to get harder for them because of the age. And like I say, they keep changing that date on Isaiah Thomas. He's going to be huge if they're going to make it out of the East.
Golden State, winner by 20, 112-92. We'll take a break. Charles Barkley said, Leroy Jensen, what happened to Elroy? This is a line, this is a joke that goes back many, many years from when it was first said.
Yeah, don't be new to the show and then try to tweet.
Yeah exactly.
I
don't believe it. I don't believe Upstairs showed that. Let's go tweet department.
J-Y-A-N-E.